Yo guys, what's going on? Acez is here today with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be giving you guys a complete guide for the map Forest here in Zero Sievert. Do me a favor, make sure you're dropping a like, and of course, make sure you're subscribing to the channel. This might be a little bit of a longer video here today, so strap in. I'm hopefully going to go over every single POI and a little in and out of the forest. So, let's hop in. All right, so the video here today is completely unscripted, so I need you to know that I could miss some information here, but when it comes to the enemies you're going to face here on the forest, you're going to encounter bandits, soldiers, you can also encounter Lazar, which is a boss, and Lazar's guards. You can also encounter a heavy amount of ghouls, not only in the main town, but also in the ghoul cave. And you will just, you know, encounter a decent amount of wildlife. You'll see some wolves, you'll see some boars, you'll see a decent amount of stuff here on the entire map, but we have a lot to work with here. And honestly, it's probably my favorite map thus far. I really enjoy playing on the forest. So down here is the Sawmill. We're going to cover that first because I have Buckshot. Lazar is here in the middle of the town near the police station. We will go over that. And if I can manage to find the Ghoul Cave, we will also try to go over that. Hopefully in this run while we're still on Buckshot. There will be randomly generated houses and little shacks all around the map. As well, make sure you are engaging with the bandits or any other soldiers you might come into. Now, the soldiers are a little bit tougher to kill. I'd probably recommend some sort of AP round. So here's one of the first anomalies. You have the fire anomaly. You can find an entire forest that looks like this. If you walk into it, it will burn you. In the giant forest, you can find yourself some fire crystals, and you also find chemical anomalies very similar as well, which will have chemical crystals in them. So this is what hidden stashes look like. They're all over the forest. You know, I'm trying to do my best to go over every single thing that you'll encounter on the forest map. So right here is a hunter. I forgot about them. They're a little bit harder to kill and usually have better weapons, but we took him out there. This one has an SV-98. And you can see we were point blank with the buckshot and it still took a few rounds to take him down. There's still a good bit of loot. I mean, there's no reason not to hit the outskirts when you don't want to engage certain situations. These stashes will get you a very hefty amount of loot. And you can see there are plenty of them on the map. All right, so still working our way to the Sawmill. Here is a bandit camp. We'll take them out. Dead. Alright, so the camp's clear. So here's some boars. I like that we're finding a little bit of everything. Shotgun takes them out quick. So there's one of the fire anomalies. There's the soldier. I'm not going to take on the soldiers, mainly because buckshot's just not the right ammunition to be taking on soldiers with. I mean, might have to actually wrap back around, see if we can sneak past them. So now we're going to work our way into the Sawmill here shortly. Oh, so somebody's already been in here killing some shit. He's got a shotty too. Him. Nice shot. Ooh. Kind of expecting maybe like a hunter to be lurking around because the one guy was dead, but I guess not. So that's the exterior of the Sawmill. Here are some of the interior buildings that you can loot. Alright, so let's head in. This is the main entrance. You're going to have a guy right around here. You're going to have one in the bathroom, and there should be one up here. That's typically where they spawn. Man, I am slacking on the reloads. Holy. That guy should have had me, but he didn't. It is what it is. We continue pushing in. There's only two guys in here. Actually, I think there's only two, and he's going to be down here, I think. No, there is three. He's got a snipe, too. Might be stuck. Got them all. So after looting your bandits, you can loot the vending machines over here. You can't loot these filing cabinets, unfortunately. You can loot both vending machines. Results may vary, of course. But truthfully, there is not that much in the sawmill. Now, like I said, I'm going to see if I can find the ghoul cave. If I can't, then I can't. It is what it is. But after we hopefully attempt to find the ghoul cave, maybe I can find some of the anomaly forest for you. And then we will move on to police station and town. Now, we could head into town and show you the exterior. Just around it. Taking out the ghouls is a lot easier with buckshot than it is with AP. Then we'll take out some wolves. Okay, some boars as well. Your wolves. This is what the chemicals look like. Now you'll find electric anomalies on other maps and other kinds of stuff, but on forest there's no electric anomalies at all. Checker. Yeah, we're a little low on buckshot. So I'm thinking we're gonna work our way to one of the extracts actually. Alright, so we survived almost 500 XP, approximately 26k made. Something light. Honestly, it's a lot easier just to go to the police station, which is what we're going to do next. Alright, we are ready for Lazar. Here's the ammunition I am using, just the AP slugs. They get the job done. So we are going to head back in. Alright, still raining, but you can see a little bit better now. It was literally 8 a.m., so I don't know why it was that dark. We got middle spawn. We're going to be heading right into the center of town. I will show you the ghouls. And we have a hunter here. Let's try and take him out. Got him. Oh! Little fucking rat. It's just like Tarkov, man. They just fucking camp in the corners and shit. Okay, we'll take a PlayStation. Damn, look at him. This hunter trying to take my loot. That's fucked up. Now, Lazar should be... Okay, he might be in the center there. Okay, I hear multiple ghouls. Gonna be one above us, or potentially in here. Let me turn the light on. I know it doesn't help much, but... Okay. I'm not sure where that one ghoul is. Hopefully he's not bugged in something and it'll hit us through the wall. Gonna push through the middle here. Wanna give yourself some space so you can, take out Lazar and the guards pretty easy. Sounds like they're fighting ghouls. One guard down. That's Lazar. Somewhere.
That's Lazar right there. I think we might have just took out Lazar, cheesed the shit out of him. Nope. Lazar's dead. Looks like they were fighting soldiers, so there could still be two more soldiers. I'm gonna rotate and check. Lazar might have beamed him, though. Might have got lucky. Now you can loot every single one of these houses. There's a shit ton of loot here. I'm going to show you all that. I'm just trying to clear out the ghouls. Because they do get a little annoying. And do an ammo check as well. Okay, we got plenty. Pushing the main a little bit. We're gonna do a soldier check. Let's see, at least one dead, maybe two. Looks like all dead. I think everybody's dead. So you have to loot Lazar to get in the police station because he will have the police key, but I'm gonna loot some soldiers. Soldier loot ain't that great for how tough they are to kill, to be honest. Here is Lazar. You'll probably want Lazar's gun. It's decent. And any guns you guys find in raids, you know, they're going to be low durability. You see the durability here. Same with Lazar's. You can repair them all if you have a workbench, I think is the right module. Highly recommended. Especially early game. Alright, so let's see what our space looks like. We're probably going to have to drop this weapon, unfortunately. I'd rather have Lazar's gun, just because we're going to head into the police station and grab the loot in here. Now, you will have a task for in here. There's going to be, like, a hidden safe in this corner, but you can open this door, and you can loot all of this. You can loot the filing cabinets. You can loot this box here and the vending machine. There are no enemies in here. As soon as you're in here, you are safe. You can do whatever you want. Do what you got to do, and you'll be good to go. And this is, like I said a little bit earlier in the video, probably the best place on the map to get yourself some loot. Now, sometimes these filing cabinets up here can have keys in them. Highly recommend not skipping the filing cabinets, specifically here in the police station. I found one filing cabinet once that had four keys in it, so make sure you just double check as well. Sometimes the looting is a little weird. All right, let's head over to the juice. Do the safes first. Kind of underwhelming, not gonna lie. Let's shoot for like a gold Zippo, something golden, anything, gold chain. I mean, I guess we'll take, you know, 1,300 rubles. It's decent, but it's not great. Attachments, this is one of those things that I'm gonna be honest. I don't know the best attachments that well, but typically like stocks and shit just don't sell as good. I'll take a gamble on those. But I just don't have enough knowledge yet. That is a suppressor. But, like, I know for a fact, like, the PPSH big-ass magazine does not sell for that. Don't need the soap. Injectors. Love getting those. And that's pretty much the police station right there. That's all the loot. We looted most of the guys. I think we looted all of them. Is there any down here that we might have missed? Now we have to loot the houses. Honestly, if you have that much loot from the police station, you really don't have to take the time. I mean, you could find something decent, but odds are you probably are better off just running to extract and, you know, coming back in. But you could find something, and I did tell you I was going to show you guys. So, of course, we'll hit some of them. Not going to hit all of them. We'll definitely get some. Anti-bleed gel. Hey, any meds we'll take. We take meds. And you can loot every single house in here. So let's get a rough direction on our extracts. We got one on the left and one on top. We'll probably head to the left, hit a couple houses on the way out. And that's pretty much your guide to the forest. I mean, there's not much else. There's the ghoul cave, which we did miss, unfortunately. But to be honest with you guys, it's really kind of unrewarding. I believe you can bring dynamite in there and blow it up, but I haven't been able to figure out how to get dynamite. I only have maybe 20 hours on the game so far, so I'm not sure about that. And also, you hear the plane. If there are airdrops, I don't know about them yet. I've never found one, so I don't know what's up with that. So there are two variables there. Okay, so it says airdrop. You know what we're fucking going for? This is going to be a first for me. This is the one thing I've never been able to get to is the airdrop. So, you know what? I'm going to check it out. Maybe it's a task, too. I don't know. So this is completely off the script. We have a shit ton of loot on us as well. Grab that water. We're kind of hurting on space. Let me get Lazar's gun loaded, too. Never know. Just in case. I'm assuming there's going to be hella ads. Maybe the military. Yeah, they're fighting somebody. I think we're actually just going to take cover in the house. We got plenty of heals in here, don't we? Yeah, let's use one of those for now. Got him. Here, another one. Why do we have an angle on that? They all dead? Nope. Damn, that's a lot of them, bro. Are they guarding this fucking airstrike? Or airdrop? Oh, shit. Solid shots. That's crazy. Oh shit, that's a big gun. I'm in the fucking tree line, I can't get an angle. Fuck, I can't see this guy. Nice shot, nice shot. Not good enough though. A little intense over here, boys. Ammo looks good. Just the airdrop right here. I think it is. I'm gonna clear the camp. I think we're clear. I've never looted one of these, so I have no idea what we're looking at. Trying to clear the entire area. Right, let's get it. Holy shit. Oh my god. Nah, there's no way. There's no way. We gotta think about this. This is a game changer right here, boys. Alright, I say we store all the shit that we got right now in the med box up here. Alright. Get this thing fully fucking looted, why not? Filling up quick. These are full dirt. Hey, that's pretty sick. Ooh, police armor in here? Okay. Oh, we can't move. We are a dummy thick. Oh, we can walk right now. So we can just slow walk to exfil right now. Can I take these attachments? They're so light. I feel like I should be able to. The attachments are a gamble. Because I don't know what they're worth. So we'd have to drop, like, one other thing. And I know I could just probably drop a few rad pills. I could drop these bandages. Yeah, we're good to go here. Alright. So, where's our exfil? It's close left. So, we're gonna slow walk it there. I probably took 15 to 20 minutes trying to get that inventory managed. But I'm assuming it's going to be worth it. The police armor could be literally worthless. I could have just took a complete gamble. I don't know. I assume they sell for a lot because from the trader, they're fucking like 27,000 or something. So I'm thinking, you know, they got to be worth at least 10K, right? I could be completely wrong. But we'll see. We're almost there. Oh, and they're putting a hidden stash right here just to tempt me with more loot. That's so disrespectful. All right. We're heading out. Let's see it. Show me 30K, at least. 66,000? Not gonna lie. That's my best raid yet on Forest. I said 30. I got 66. Alright, so let me see. What is the police armor worth? 6,000? That's a little underwhelming, I'm not gonna lie. But, alright, I knew that was worth a lot. Let's see how we did on attachments. Like, the mag's not worth it. But we'll put all the attachments in here, see how we did. Is that all of them? So we got 12K in attachments. You know, that's not bad. Attachments are fairly light. We'll take that. Alright, so I'll at least show you me selling some of the stuff, mainly all the attachments, because I do not mod out my weapons. You really don't need to, at least for me yet in the game. So there's 12K, and we can get another 5K out of them here with some of the chains. Let's go ahead and throw the gold chain back. Got 4K. Nope, still went over. Throw the ciggies in there. Nope, we're still over. Alright, so we'd have to sleep again to get the restock, so let's do that. Alright, so the PlayStation, the repair kit, which I thought this was going to be worth more. I had no idea. I mean, this is 2 kgs and it's only worth 660. Had no idea. We probably won't even sell that, to be honest. Now, the weapon repair kit was some good money. Then we can probably swing almost all 18k. What do we want to do? Buy it. Well, we need a little bit of stuff anyway. So we can throw the stims on there. And what do we want to do to make up the difference? Right there. Good to go. So, guys, that is the forest in its entirety. Besides the ghoul cave, what the ghoul cave is just a little stone circle. And there's a small entrance you can go in. And basically, there's probably like 20 to 30 ghouls in there. You take all of them out. And you can basically just take the tentacles that they drop. There's not much else really to the ghoul cave. Like I said, I think you can blow it up with dynamite, I read. But to be honest with you, I haven't figured out how to do that. So that's why it wasn't really included in the video here today. Guys, if you enjoyed it, make sure you drop a like. Spend a lot of time on this one. We've been recording for about an hour. So I would greatly appreciate the support. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. We're going to be doing a task guide for every single task in the game on a separate save. So it's going to be a task-only account. So make sure you're looking out for that. And yeah, so leave a like, subscribe, sponsored equipment description below. That's going to be it. Thanks so much for stopping by. I'm out.